Hi and welcome to another Bitwig episode. In today's episode, we'll focus on the relation between the clip launcher and the arranger. I get a ton of questions on working with the clip launcher in the Bitwig Studio Masterclass course, so it's time we take a closer look. Importantly, learn about how to record your clip launching performance into the arranger, so you can finally bounce and export your music performance into a master audio file. If you're new to Bitwig and just want to learn the basics and record into clips, I highly recommend you watch my previous episodes by clicking the card up here. And there's always links to these episodes in the video description. My name is Mattias, let's take the tour. Right, so I've prepared a project here with a bunch of clips, and we also have a little bit of MIDI material in the arranger. So let's briefly talk about the difference between the arranger and the clip launching. The arranger is for a horizontal composition, and the clip launching is for a non-linear composition. So you can basically launch and mix and match different clips. And you can, of course, hide and show these different views if you want just to work in the arranger maybe, or want to work at these two at the same time. And by default, my project is now playing all the clips from the arrangement timeline. So let's just press play. And if I want to instead play all the tracks from the clip launching view, I either launch a scene or I launch some of the clips. So we can launch a scene from the top bar here. So let's launch scene 4 to begin with. And then maybe launch scene 3. I'm just using the machine jam here to launch the different scenes. So you can also mix and match the playback between the arranger and the clip launching. And that's where the buttons in the middle here comes into play. So if I press one of these switch playback to arranger timeline buttons, you can see that the clips on the arrangement view will light up. And that means that if we play back this arrangement, you will hear the MIDI in this case from the arrangement timeline rather than the clips. So let's press play here again. So you can see that all the other clips have the play button activated, except the melody Zebra HZ, because it's playing the MIDI from the arrangement timeline. So that's how you mix and match these. And now we can also maybe play this poly 80s chord, also from the arrangement view. So let's press this button. And it will exclude the clip launching and play these clips from the arranger instead. The same thing, if we press play here, we will hear the clips from the arranger mixed with some clip launching scene clips. And if you completely want to stop all the clip launching, you have to press this stop button to the left side of each of the tracks, or you press the button at the top here, which will exclude all the clip launching. And now we can activate this switch to arrangement timeline. And that means that we will only play back clips that resides in the arrangement timeline. So now if we press the spacebar to play, we will only hear clips and audio from the arrangement view rather than the clip launching. And of course, you can also mix in and play clips from the clip launching if you want at the same time. So let's press play here and launch a few clips during the performance. Maybe launch a ride. But you also have to be careful if you're working this way, that you're launching at the same bar lengths, because if not, they are going to play at different places, like I did in that demo. You can see that by this play bar on the different clips. This white play bar. So now is a good time to launch the drums. Right, so that's mixing and matching clips from the clip launcher and from the arrangement timeline. It's also possible to drag clips between the clip launching and the arrangement view and vice versa. So let's take the poly 80s chord and drag that to the arrangement timeline and activate the playback from arrangement timeline. And as we said, you can also drag this back into a clip if you need to. So that's just a quick way to swap clips between the clip launcher and arrangement. But how about you want to record your clip launching performance into the arrangement timeline for a full performance? And just press the stop button to go back to the beginning of the arrangement and activate the record button and launch any of your scenes. And you will see that those will be recorded into the arrangement timeline. So now everything that you do after that will be recorded into the arrangement. So you can finally make that export into your master audio file. So let's launch scene number 4. We can actually launch that from the machine jam. So now when we stop the recording, you can see that all the clips in the arrangement timeline, they're in this kind of transparent state. And that means that they are disabled and we're still in clip launching mode for all the tracks. And now to jump over to the arrangement playback, we can just press this switch to arrangement timeline playback button. So now we basically have that music performance burned into the arrangement. And we can still make edits, of course, into the arrangement and further refine this before we make the final bounce and export. So if we open the automation for maybe the ride here, you can see that all these automation that I made on the remote control here, the keystep 37, it's recorded into this performance. So if we play back this arrangement, all the changes that you heard during the clip launching performance, they are actually recorded here into the arrangement. I do recommend that you press this restore automation control button before you play back the arrangement, so you make sure that all the automation will play back correctly. So let's play back the arrangement. Right, so now we're basically ready to export this as a final master audio file. And to do that, we can just hold the Shift command and press B, and we get to the export audio menu. And we can select if we want to export this into a WAV file, an MP3 file, or both of them at the same time. And it's important to press the loop region selection here, so that we make sure to export the selected area that I selected with this gray top bar in the arrangement. And then finally press OK to just export the whole project, and let's give it a name. Bitwig 5 clip launching. Right, so that's basically how you work with the clip launcher and the arrangement, and how you finally get your clip launching performances into the arrangement timeline, so that we can make the export of our final master audio file. Now, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Okay, if you want to learn more about Bitwig Studio, I highly recommend you sign up to my Bitwig Studio Masterclass at store.morningdewmedia.com. See you in the course. My name is Mattias, bye.